Bismillahirrahmani. Assalamu alaikum dear cadets. Today our topic is law of conservation of momentum. This law is only applicable for an isolated system, and this is only for use for two or more than two bodies. First of all, we see the statement of isolated system and law of conservation of momentum. Statement: the momentum of an isolated system of two or more than two bodies interacting each other remain constant before and after collision. What is isolated system? That system in which two or more than two bodies are interacting each other, but there is no external force on it. I want to say that two bodies which are interacting each other, but there is no external force on it, that system is basically not possible in universe. Now if we see that explanation, consider two bodies M1 consider two bodies A and B whose masses M1 and M2 and moving with velocities U1, initial velocities U2. This is the system of bodies A and B, which masses are M1 and M2 and their velocities are U1 and U2. Initial velocities are U1 and U2. After some time t, so momentum, initial momentum of body A equal to m1 u1. Initial momentum of body B equal to m2 u2. That is the initial momentum of body A, which is m1 u1, and initial momentum of body B is equal to m2 u2. Now total initial momentum of the whole system, total initial momentum of system before collision it will be m1 u1 plus m2 u2. That is called equation number 1. Total initial momentum of system before collision m1 and u1, m2 and u2. We can say if we increase the speed of the body A, then if U1 greater than U2, it means that we increase the velocity or speed of the body A, then body A will strike the body B. We can see that M1 will strike M2. This point is called point of impact. When we increase the velocity of body A, then the body A strike the body B, and that point which collide, that point this point is called point of impact or point of collision. After collision, now these bodies moving with velocities v1 and v2 in the same direction. After collision, body A m1, body B m2 moving with velocity v1 and v2 in the same direction. This is the momentum of system after collision. So we can write that final momentum of body A will be m1 v1. Final momentum of body B will be m2 v2. Now the total final momentum of the system. Total final momentum of the system after collision. Which will be m1 v1 plus m2 v2, that is called 2. According to law of conservation of momentum, the momentum of the initial momentum before collision is equal to final momentum after collision. According to law of conservation of momentum, total initial momentum, total initial momentum of system before collision equal to total final momentum. Total final momentum of system after collision. Total initial momentum of system before collision will be m1 u1 plus m2 u2 equal to total final momentum of system after collision, which will be m1 v1 plus m2 v2. As we know that we already defined that m1 u1 plus m2 u2 equation 1 and m1 v1 plus m2 v2 equation 2. Combine both these equations, then we will find that total initial momentum of system before collision, which is m1 u1 plus m2 u2, total final momentum of system after collision, which is m1 v1 plus m2 v2. According to law of conservation of momentum, the total initial momentum of the system of two or more than two bodies equal to total final momentum of the bodies, which is law of conservation of momentum, and this is the mathematical form of law of conservation of momentum. That was our today topics. Inshallah, next topic we will discuss tomorrow. Thank you.